All right, back again. So I'm still on intro stage here. You were saying about, like, I think last night Renato something about the bass or something. Like, want me to increase it just a hair? Yeah, I can hear the bass. I can hear it through my headphones, so it's no problem there. So let me get a MIDI file ready for Launch Octopus because I want to start that so raw. I actually want to start that all over again. Get the sound font. Okay, check 10 seconds. Let me check a SPC tool. I hear like more of the lows in the SCP file rather than the highs. So I'm just gonna I increase the lows a bit, so let's see. Sounds pretty good to me. Okay, what's next? Yeah, launch octopus. Gonna see what you type next before I move on. That's because I take the I take that option where you can have it spread, but it didn't sound really good compared to the rest of the instruments, so I put it back toward the right, which is supposed to be panned to the right, the bass. Oops, wrong one. Yeah, the panning is correct. All right, so yeah, I'm gonna move on now. Launch Octopus. Yeah, it's a frequency thing, basically. Okay, let's see. Now, on this one, the bass is gonna need some work now. It's the bass's turn now to receive the volume more treatment. This is actually also the first time that I've seen the bass have some sort of delay. So the bass is going to have some delay, and it's the slap bass. And it has a sound, and I have to put like a flanger effect on it, so it has that underwater type feel sound. Don't know why it sounds like that, but. Actually, maybe So yeah, bass. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Oops, I missed some notes here. Oh, big oof. So this part's the only part that's gonna have that delay. So it starts to the left. But I think this is the original. Yeah. A notepad? No, I don't. Yeah, I don't have a notepad. Cam back. So these are the original notes. Give it a mixer channel, and we're gonna add a 3-step delay here. Too much. So quarter, that's And we need to give it that flanger effect. I want to use the chorus. Can't Reaper want a bass. It's heresy. Well, in Mega Man's X case, yes, there is some sort of modifications on the bass. On the bass. I don't know why I said bass. That's a fish, but whatever. Yeah, because it's supposed to sound like, underwater. Okay, so. Okay, so. Bass is done. It was next. And it crashed again. So we have the synth and the guitar now. This is Launch Octopus. Then we're gonna make a synth pattern. Oh, I put it in the wrong one. Oh, well. Guitar. But there needs to be like some sort of pitch bend somewhere in here. Why'd I open that? So here's the part where I need to put that small pitch bend here. But first, let me set the control to semitones. There we go. and we get delay. Okay. I need to give that synth some, that bit of that vibrato effect. And let's give it some release time. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Oops. That pitch knob is still, I don't know why it's in that position still. What is that one PS1 soundtrack you would like to restore? Basically the Resident Evil series, mostly Resident Evil 3, but you know, I don't know how that can be possible because there's no way to convert the PSX files to MIDI, you know, whatever sound format they use. Okay, so it's good for the synth. Oh, wait, the guitar. Cannot forget about the guitar. Just loop twice. That guitar pitch bend. Checks. So let's check the pitch. What?
Love you, Christy.
Alright, I'm back. Sorry about that, guys. Okay, so we're on the guitar. Give this a mixer track. So we have a couple of pitch bends we have to take care of in here. Which we can actually replace these with. It's easier because now we can replace these with a slide belt. So and delete this. Almost. That works. Yeah, there we go. Delay track now. that out of the way. So now's the percussion. Yay, percussion. Same here. So I'm going to copy the automation going on here. Thank you. percussion where anything can go wrong. Yeah, like fret turning wrong. Because we're not all about that raw shit. We're about that cooked. Nice and cooked. Well done. Crash symbol. Okay, so we're gonna copy the thing, whatever, the canning. So here's the tricky one. Alright, so gonna get that orchestral hit. Okay, so it's gonna have echo notes like. It's gonna be a little tricky. Okay, so there might be an echo. Yeah, right here. And it crashed. Okay, so this delay has to be a lot longer. should be the right pitch. Anyways. So 2 1/4. There we go. Oh, I gotta delete the, I forgot to delete the notes here. Yeah, I think this sounds pretty good. Orchids, the pitch. Yeah. But I think I got the right pitch. Let me double check again. Oops. We'll see how that sounds in the final product. Let me double check our delay again. So now for that little bell thing. Which of course has some delay on it. My plugin. I think these are the right bells. Okay. So we need a delay on the bells. Right out of the box. Save it. So we have to do our second layer of percussion, which see. Thank you. Okay. Okay. There we go. So, since we're going to copy some volume automation in here as well. Awesome. Okay, so let's call this pattern. That's number two. Give it a mixer channel. So, all right, so we need that snare. Okay, so see if there's any automation going on here. Okay, so now we need to crash. Okay. No, I didn't want the whole thing. But that snare needs to also be in the right place, so I gotta double check on that. Check for automation. I really don't think there's automation on the snare and the crash, so we'll leave it as is. So, our last part of the percussion now. Should be fairly straightforward. Got the kicks. And then, what is this up here? That is weird. Why would they put a kick note on a higher pitch? Okay, well, so what we're gonna have to do is, I hate doing this, but I'm gonna have to create another instance. Because I don't have the raw kick. Do I have the raw kick? Because I like the one from the plugin the best. Should be a bass drum. Now we've got to use the one from the plugin. Actually, I'm gonna use the raw kick. And just use the plugin. Me copy that raw kick in here. Why did I close it? Where are we putting this at? Wait, did I just copy the snare instead? Yeah, I did. Why did I do that? There we go. Just make it just yeah, kick one. Kick two, but it's all going in the same kick pattern. Kick thing I meant. So number 11. And we're going to copy all the bottom notes here. The rest of the kick pattern. But I want to lower the velocity a little bit, so it's not so loud. There we go. And this is panned a little bit to the right. And same volume automation, nothing special really. All right, so I think that's about does it for the percussion. We did that. Now here's the fun part, putting the pieces of the puzzle together. You guys are saying same effect, same settings for consistency, unless everything has sound muffled in the bar, which in this case it kind of does, like at least for the bass. The other stuff is fine. Mute everything. Yeah, sounds with the percussion. Too loud. That orchestra hit sounds a little bit weird, so we're gonna have to like tweak that a bit. So synth, kind of want to put it let's put our percussion up here. Bells and the guitar. Then the bass. We can just, because it's like the rest we can just slice and delete, because it's just mostly like a loop. So, I don't know, I still don't know what the pitch on the orc hit. weird. Nope, it's too high. There we go. Want to add an exciter though. It sounds too muffled. There we go. Let's actually, you know, give it some saturation up. Saturation over to the same thing with the hats. for us. All right, so it looks like it's coming together pretty nicely. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take like a 10-minute break, and then I'm gonna come back and, well, what I always do, TSR the hell out of everything. So yeah, we're gonna add some TSR and, tweak more as needed, compensate for that re extra reverb. So yeah, so I'll be right back. All right, y'all, back. So, gonna do some reverb on this. For some reason I'm getting like latency. Weird, I don't know why. Thank you. All right, let me check the original. Oh, I forgot to add vibrato on the guitar. Why didn't you remind me, Renato, that the guitar had vibrato? Come on, man, you're supposed to. You're supposed to, remind me of this. Nah, I'm joking, man. All right, so looks pretty healthy. Thank you. I think it's done, yo. Okay, let's do the loop. Let's add our fade out. Let's export it and make a FLAC file as well while I'm at it. Yeah, so I'm gonna take a break, and then in an hour I'm gonna come back and go into the next one, which is, let's see. The next one should be password screen. So that should be, pretty simple to polish. And then after that, it's gonna be the Sigma fight tunes. And then, you know, most of the Sigma stuff. So, you know, Spark Mandrill, the stage stuff, Steam Chameleon, and the title theme, and, you know, going down the list. So, yeah. Alright, so, see you in a few.